These hoes is on motherfucking Twitter talking about something. Oh my God, Brian, I'm praying for you. You in my prayers, Brian. Don't worry about it. Everything gonna be okay. Something, something through the night, but joy comes in the morning. You know, some shit quoted from the Bible. You know, some shit like that. And I'm looking at these motherfuckers like, girl, did Beyonce teach us nothing? Beyonce said, stop the motherfucking track. Let me state motherfucking facts. I told you, give me your minute and I'll be right back. And bitch, I'm here. President.
Girl, I'm going to say this, girl. I'm going to say this. And a lot of the girls from the Hive is not going to be with me on this, girl. A lot of the girls from the Hive is not going to feel me on this. But I don't give a monkey fuck. I really don't give a monkey's fuck, girl. Because I'm going to say this shit anyway. Beyonce is Sasha. And Sasha is Beyonce. I know y'all sitting there like, bitch, what the fuck? What the fuck is he talking about? I'm confused. Well, bitch, I'm here to explain it to you. Beyonce is Sasha, and Sasha is Beyonce. Because, bitch, like I told you, Beyonce knows what she got. Beyonce knows everything that Beyonce is. That bitch said, look, my motherfucking ear can do this shit. Wait, hold on. This shit right here. You know what I'm saying? That bitch said my motherfucking elbow could do this shit right here. You know what I'm saying? That bitch said my hands could do this shit. That bitch knows who the fuck she is. She knows herself from motherfucking head to motherfucking toe. Okay, bitch? Hold on. But bitch, hold on. Let me explain. Beyonce is so fucking beautiful. She's so fucking amazing. So God's gift to the world that if she was just to come off like she know it, when she knows, she already knows it, but if she was to come off that way, the world would fucking hate her. The world would just hate this pretty, gorgeous-ass, talented bitch. They would just hate her ass. So she's got to play it down. She's got to be modest. So she created this persona, Sasha, who she turns into when she goes on stage. Bitch, please. I'm going to tell you when Beyonce turns into Sasha, and it's not when she's on stage. Because Sasha is too self-centered to be dancing on top of some other bitch's name, Beyonce. She's too self-centered for that shit, girl. I'm going to tell you when Beyonce turns into Sasha. Beyonce turns into Sasha when she does interviews. That's when Beyonce turns into a fake bitch. Each and every time she turns into somebody who she ain't. When Beyonce does the interview, she becomes a fake robotic-ass bitch. That is Sasha. But when she's on stage, that's the real Beyonce. That's the real Beyonce right there. That bitch that come out on that motherfucker like, bitch, who the fuck? That's the real motherfucking Beyonce, girl. And if you're mad, bitch, be mad, ho, because that's the motherfucking truth. Be told, girl. Beyonce Single Ladies is basically Beyonce sitting down for tea with us to tell us how she got Jay-Z to propose. That's all that is, girl. That's all she doing. She telling us how she got Jay-Z to propose on some Freakum Dress shit, girl, because that's all she did. She just took what she learned from Freakum Dress. She went up in the motherfucking club, acting a motherfucking fool, and next thing you know, Jay-Z is on his motherfucking knees proposing, girl. Yes, man, bitch, and I'm about to do the same motherfucking thing, Beyonce, bitch. I'm about to take a motherfucking page out your book, bitch, because I'm about to get me a motherfucking Freakum Dress to see if I can get Diggy down on his motherfucking knees. Who am I kidding? I don't even need a dress to get Diggy down on his knees. Bloop! Beyonce's Diva. Bitch, when I tell you, that song gave me life beyond life, bitch. Okay, it gave me life beyond life. On some bitch, I died, I was crucified, I was put in a motherfucking cave, and I came back on some beyond life. Shit, you know what I'm saying, girl? That song right there, bitch, I remember what I was when I first heard that song, girl. I remember where I was, girl. I was in my Beamer and shit, driving down the motherfucking street. I was in Union, New Jersey at Five Points, girl. I had just left the motherfucking Galloping Hills to give me a hot dog. You know what I'm saying, girl? So I'm driving down the motherfucking street and shit with the blinker on the opposite direction of where I was turning in the wrong motherfucking lane because, bitch, that's how I drive. That's how I motherfucking drive. So anyhow, bitch, I'm motherfucking driving down the street and shit. So I start flicking the motherfucking stations. Psh, 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 psh. And I get some motherfucking Hot 97. And Flex dropped the bomb on it. I'm a diva. I'm a diva. I'm a bitch. I ain't been the same since. I ain't been the motherfucking same since. When I tell you Beyonce attacked that motherfucking song, girl, Beyonce attacked that shit so messy, so reckless. I'm talking reckless like Brandy on a motherfucking parkway in a Range Rover. Okay, bitch, you know what I'm saying? That bitch might be able, that alien bitch, excuse me, might be able to hop in a motherfucking UFO and take off and hit every motherfucking planet from Mercury to motherfucking Pluto. But the bitch cannot drive down motherfucking I-95. No ma'am, bitch. No ma'am. So any whore, tramp, trollop ass motherfucking sluts, bitch. And I don't know when the rap industry is going to give Beyonce the credit that she deserves as being one of the best female rappers, if not the best motherfucking female rapper out right now, bitch. Right now, bitch. I mean, if we can give motherfucking Nicki Minaj credit as being a fucking female rapper with that Nickelodeon fucking Ellen Show bullshit that she puts out, you know what I'm saying? Then we can give it the credit to a real rapper like Beyonce. If anybody came close to filling Lauryn Hill's shoes, it's motherfucking Beyonce. Bitch, I said it and I say it motherfucking again, bitch. Okay, if you want to see me, come right here, bitch. I'm here. And I will fight you over that, girl. I will fight you, bitch. Beyonce has, if damn it. First of all, Beyonce, I'm just going to be honest, bitch. Beyonce has slipped on Lauryn Hill's shoes, wore them bitches out, had them shits running over to the left, okay? Because she don't wore them shits out and went on to somewhere else, bitch, okay? Get me started on my motherfucking Beyonce, girl. Beyonce was just messy when it came to Diva Girl. Beyonce was just messy throughout the entire song, bitch. Beyonce came for every bitch in the motherfucking industry. She came for every bitch in sight, okay? I don't give a fuck if you was chilling her motherfucking peripheral. She came for y'all bitches too, you know what I'm saying? She came for every bitch's neck in the industry. And after she came for them hoes sat there quiet with the motherfucking hush mouth. Beyonce read the motherfucking industry like teleprompters in this bitch. Understand me, girl? Understand me, bitch. And the only bitch, and I'm gonna give this bitch credit right now. I'm gonna give this bitch credit right now for having heart. The only bitch that had the heart to step to Beyonce was a stranger bitch. That was the only bitch that had the heart to step to Beyonce was a stranger bitch. Yes, it was career suicide. Yes, her career is over. Yes, she is now performing in the closest motherfucking Walmart to you. But the bitch had the heart to step to Beyonce. Yes, the beehive has stung, and still stinging that bitch on a regular basis. But still, the bitch had the heart to step to Beyonce. So we got to give it to that unknown stranger bitch whose name I will not repeat, because I ain't got time to Google it, girl, because I can't remember it off the top of my motherfucking head. Girl, I need you to listen and understand, girl. I need you to listen and motherfucking understand, because I'm about to quote Beyonce, girl. I'm about to quote the motherfucking queen, girl, because the bitch said, bunny ears. Every night I rush to my bed with hopes that maybe I get a chance to see when I close my eyes. I'm going out of my head, lost in my fairy tale. Could you hold my hand and be my guide? Bunny ears. That bitch was talking about masturbation, girl. That bitch was talking about masturbation because she was missing a Jay-Z. Because keep in mind, bitch, during that time, bitch, that bitch was off and away at motherfucking tour and Jay-Z wasn't around. That bitch was sitting in that motherfucking bed going to ham on that Beyonce coochie, girl. She was, you know, whatever the girls do, girl. I don't know what the fuck the bitches do. I know it got something to do with these two fingers, girl. And they go ham with them, girl. But any gay, anyway, girl. You know what I'm saying? Anybody who has been in a long-distance relationship, or whose boo is off in the military somewhere, or whose boo always has to go on business trips. Well, girl, if your boo went on a business trip all the time, especially they go on a business trip in Atlanta. Any gay girl. Another story for another video, girl. But anyhow, anybody who has a boo that's gone away and has been away for a while, they know that when you come home, you rush to your motherfucking bed, and you be thinking about him. Even though Beyonce was lying down in that bed going ham on that snatch. Going ham on that monkey. You know what I'm saying? Going ham on that coochie pop pop. You know, it got all kinds of names for it, girl. It's got a whole bunch of nicknames, girl. I ain't know, girl. I just found out the other day, girl. But any gay, anyway, girl. Going ham on a girl. It just wasn't enough. You know what I'm saying? Because Beyonce was really missing Jay-Z's big ego. You know what I'm saying, girl? So Beyonce had to take it to another level, girl. And this right here is going to segue me into the next motherfucking scene, girl. Because I'm going to tell you what the bitch did.
Because I did it too.
But girl, like I was saying, if you ever apart from your boo, and the two of you just so happen to have a video phone, that phone could bring the two of y'all closer and help you have a happy ending to your motherfucking night, bitch. Yes, bitch. I'm talking about right here, bitch. What? Girl, picture it. 2009. Diggy and I, we both had our iPhones. Now, this was before FaceTime, girl. This was before FaceTime. So, anyhow, any gay, anyway, I was on the phone with my girl, Christy. And I'm going back and forth with my girl, Christy. Bop, 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 bop. Yeah, bitch. Bop, 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 bop. Girl, bop, 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 bop. You know what I'm saying? Going back and forth with my bitch, Christy, right? So Christy was like, Brian, do you and Diggy know about this new app called Knocking? I was like, no. What'd it do? I'm sorry, I don't know nothing about it. She was like, well, the two of you can see each other in real time if y'all both download this app. Bitch, when I tell you I was here with a girl, you say I can see him right now? She was like, yeah, bitch, you can see him right. Girl, I'm going to call you back. Girl, I was in the Apple store like, bitch, where the fuck? Where the fuck that shit? Did the bitch say Knocking? Did the bitch say... Bitch, when I pull that motherfucking shit up on my motherfucking phone, raw. Diggy, you gotta download this motherfucking app now. Girl, and the thing about this damn app, girl, was the best thing in the world, girl. I loved this app at the time, girl. Like I said, it was before FaceTime. Every time, you know, either I would knock Diggy or Diggy would knock me, because we didn't call it Knocking, we called it Knock Knock. That was the nickname for it for us. It was Knock Knock, right? So anyhow, anytime you open up this app and you go to knock on Diggy's door, Diggy would knock on my motherfucking door, go. Just like that, every single time, girl. It was just like a little knocking sound, right? Girl, it got to a point that I couldn't hear a knock without getting hard. I couldn't hear fucking, people would be coming over my house and shit, they'd be knocking on the door, my shit would be like, poof. I'm like, shit, could y'all ring the doorbell in this bitch? Could you, fuck, shit. You know what I'm saying? I couldn't. Just the sound of a knock used to make me brick, bitch. Girl, child, I had some good nights off of that motherfucking app. Holly, holly. The girl, y'all better not tell Diggy shit. Y'all better not tell him I brought this shit up, girl. Because if y'all tell him I brought this shit up, I will deny it. I will deny. I will deny. I will deny. That's so annoying. What's the best way for me to explain Beyonce's radio? And I think the best way for me to do this is with a story. Actually, a story that came from the Bee's own mouth, girl. A story that came from the Bee. I don't remember where this interview came from. I think it was with Beyonce and David Letterman. I'm thinking, girl, but I could be wrong, so don't quote me on it, girl. But anyhow, Beyonce said, in the back days, girl, when she was just a teeny little girl, when she was just a teeny girl, you know what I'm saying? She used to bring boys up to her bedroom. Oh, excuse me. Boy, because Beyonce wants me to believe that this was a one-time occurrence, girl, that she only did this one time, girl. Mm-hmm, Beyonce. Mm-hmm, Beyonce. So any gay, so any hoe, and I do mean hoe. So Beyonce brought this boy up to her bedroom, right? And her and the boy, I think she said the two of them was kissing, right? So Solange walks past, clocks the motherfucking tea, and she runs downstairs, girl. She runs the fuck downstairs, and she goes to tell her mother, Tina Knowles, who was fierce to death, girl. The Beyonce of her motherfucking time, right? She runs downstairs and tells Tina Knowles that Beyonce is upstairs doing a motherfucking nasty, girl. So Tina Knowles runs upstairs, busts it all up and shit, kicks the motherfucking boy out of the house, just all types of motherfucking drama, girl, because Beyonce was trying to get her cootie wet by this boy, girl. So anyhow, girl, now, Beyonce is that type of girl that likes to make a lot of noise when she gets fucked, girl. She likes to be very vocal when she's getting dick down, girl. She likes to be very vocal, and I love that, girl. I love that bitch that shows up, girl. I love it, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Even if you're not feeling it for real, show the fuck up, okay, girl? Because a power bottom, girl, they just sit there, girl. I can't stand that shit. But anyhow, anyway, girl. Beyonce shows the fuck up when she gets dick down and she makes a lot of noise. So the only way to drown out the noise is to turn up the motherfucking radio, bitch. That bitch turns up the radio so that you can't hear her go boom. But you know that she in the motherfucking zone. You know what I'm saying, girl? But you know she in the motherfucking zone. Because, girl, let me clock T for you, girl. Let me clock T, girl, for you. Now, if you slow it down, when Beyonce says, and I fall in love with my stereo whenever I hear the sound, oh, 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 oh. Now, if you slow it down, that bitch is saying, and I fall in love with my stereo whenever I hear the sound, oh, 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 yes, man, bitch, you better get dick down with the radio on full blast so that can't nobody hear your nasty ass. Yes, ma'am.
Boy.